Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we're going to show you how to set up and shut down the oxy-acetylene torch set. Woo! And hopefully we won't get a bang out of it. Let's go! First, congratulations on clicking the QR code in the project booklet that leads you to this video. Show me this on your digital device for a free bonus mark for your project, because I applaud your resourcefulness. Good job. Now, we've covered oxyacetylene in class. You watched a video, you took notes, I demoed it in class, so you could see how to do this. But you might have forgotten, so here's the little refresher. First, a little bit of safety. I'm wearing a shop coat. I recommend you wear the leather jackets from the welding booth. It protects your clothes a bit better. I'm also wearing leather gloves. We provide gloves here. I like these ones because they fit tighter to my fingers, give me a bit dexterity. I don't like burning my skin, so I'm going to use some dead cow. Also, I'm going to wear tinted goggles so that I can see what I'm doing. These prevent sparks from getting into your eyes. Make sure you still have these little plugs which prevent it from fogging up on you, but they need to be there. If they aren't, come and get me. Just in case I'm not right here, the instructions for the safety, how to start it, and how to shut it off are right here on the wall. Don't be afraid to look at those. Second, I'm going to demo it again for you right now. Torch. This is the torch body and the handle. These are the valves that open and close the gases that we're going to burn. Acetylene is your flame. It's an unstable gas, but it works awesome for welding. The oxygen here is not breathable oxygen, but it's the green hose. This is not for breathing. This is probably going to kill you, so we don't huff this stuff. The tips can be changed. This is a number one tip, which is kind of in the middle. If things are like getting way too hot, you can go down to a zero or a double zero or a triple zero. And if they're not heating up enough, you can go to a number one or a number two. There we go, just to a double zero for giggles. So we're gonna put this on here. They're just done up finger tight, okay? They do have a hex on them, don't put a wrench on them. I'm right-handed, and so I like to hold the torch like this with the valves easily accessible and the tip going in that direction. If you're a lefty, you might wanna set it up this way so that the torch valves are here and the tips going that way. You can do it other ways. I've seen some people weld with the valves on the back side of their hand so that they aren't in the way when you're welding. Doesn't really matter, whatever works for you. Okay, to light it. Acetylene is usually, but not always, the short tank. I always back off the regulators to make sure that nobody has done something stupid before I get here. I am a control freak and I wanna have things controlled. We're gonna open this up slowly, twist of the wrist, half a turn. So if there's an emergency, we can shut it off quickly, not, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. No, we wanna shut it off quick. So twist of the wrist, half a turn is usually pretty good. This gauge normally goes up, but this tank is almost empty, so it's not showing anything. Hopefully we still have enough pressure to work with. I want 5 pounds per square inch. So I turn the regulator in. Good idea to have this open to check. That's about 5, we're good. Sometimes when this is closed, these creep. So I like to set it while it's running. The oxygen tank is also a little unstable and kind of has its own levels of danger too. Again, I'm gonna back off the regulators and make sure they're loose so that I have control of what pressure is in there. I'm gonna crack open this tank super slowly. I don't like to stand in front of the gauges. I've seen them explode when hammered by the pressure. Because this is a high pressure tank, I'm gonna open it all the way. I like the environment, but not enough to pay money to fill it full of welding gas that I bought. So this is gonna open all the way. It has 2 seals, so it seals at the bottom when it's closed and it seals at the top when it's open, so the oxygen doesn't leak its way through the valve. So all the way, half a turn, all the way, half a turn. Once that's up, and this one's got this half full, it's got 1,000 PSI in it. Again, I'm gonna crack that open a little bit, crank in the regulator till it gets to 5 PSI and we're good. I did put marks on these gauges so you can find 5 PSI in case you don't understand Arabic numbers. Once that's set, I can light this. Lighting it, you're gonna use a striker. Strikers are used for lighting. Lighting is done by strikers. Nothing other than a striker, only a striker, just a striker. I'm not allowed to strike you. Then, crack this open. I'm opening the red hose. I'm just cracking it open a little bit. Boom, and it lights up. You can see it going. And I'm going to play with this by adjusting this red knob here. I'm gonna adjust this with either less acetylene or more acetylene. And I go until the smoke just disappears. See all that smoke? Smoke is just disappearing. And then we're good. Now, don't mess with this. Once the red is set to no smoke, it's good. Leave it. Now we go to the green hose, the oxygen. And I crack that open slowly. Oh man, it's already soothing. This looks like this tip could use a cleaning. So if you look at this tip, there's a couple different ways to set the flame. Not enough oxygen is a carbonizing flame. It's a little bit lower temperature and it's gonna add a lot of soot to your weld and make your weld brittle. Neutral flame is the one we're shooting for. That's the perfect burn. It should be the best for your weld. This is a higher temperature. It's gonna make your weld, it adds oxygen, it'll make your weld porous. Once you finish your welding and you're ready to shut her down, we're gonna shut the red hose. Shutting off the fuel keeps the oxygen going, which keeps the flame out of the tip. It keeps the tip from getting dirty quickly. Once the acetylene is shut off, then you shut off the oxygen. Make sure you shut off both, please. Then, the torch valves are off. We're gonna close the tank valves. So I'm going, this oxygen is gonna be closed all the way. Acetylene is closed all the way. You ain't done yet. We still have pressures in here. We wanna get rid of that. So, with the tanks closed, now we bleed off whatever's in the line. You'll see these needles go down to zero. Same thing with this one. You'll see these go to zero. When they've hit zero and the gas stops coming out, you're good. Okay? Then, close the valves, okay? Closed, keep them closed. Back off the regulators so you can make the next person set the pressures too. Don't be afraid to check out the instructions on the wall in case you can't remember, and they pay me to help you. If you don't ask me for help, they still pay me. So, don't be afraid. And, thanks for watching. Take care.